नमस्ते एंड गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, ऑल ऑफ यू, ऑल माय फ्रेंड्स देयर एंड हियर अगेन. आई एम टुडे विथ अ न्यू सूत्रा, विथ न्यू टॉक्स, विथ न्यू थिंग्स टू डिस्कस विथ यू ऑल. एंड थैंक यू फॉर गेनिंग द नॉलेज. इफ़ यू आर वॉचिंग माई वीडियोज, द ओल्ड वीडियोज ऑल्सो, इट इज़ गोइंग टू गिव यू अ गुड इनसाइट. एंड देर इज़ वन क्वेश्चन विच वॉज आस्क्ड आई थिंक डे बिफोर, and there was a personal message, so that is what I wanted to answer today. And that question was okay, so Amit is here and happy birthday Amit. I wished you in the morning blessings and lots of wishes for you, for your beautiful life, okay, and your family too. So again I continue here that there was a question ki you are providing us so many techniques, and don't you think that a master is necessary, or a teacher is necessary, or a guru is necessary while I am following this technique? So there is more things to add upon this. You are welcome Amit. Okay, so there is more to think and reflect on this, that when you have your own way, there are 112 ways. Master really makes a difference, but here there are 112 ways for you to follow and for you to travel inside you, for you to work out. And then if there is the guru's way, that is the 112th is the option if you would like to go for a guru or a teacher. And that why I say this is, you are being lazy to try. Tantra is not about being lazy. Tantra is all about performance, all about action, all about trying different techniques, trying to reach yourself. So guru is not the person, and it is all about our deep conditioning. It's a conditioning from generations. We feel that always knowledge is given to us. We need a teacher to gain knowledge. We need a guru. We need a master if you would like to go for spiritual knowledge. And that isn't true. It is your journey, and if you would like to attain knowledge, no one can stop you. Knowledge is free. Love is free. You don't need anyone to gain them. But the child is born, we say the mother is the first guru of the child, and then we hand over our child to the teacher. And still, if I talk to teenagers and youngsters, what you would like to learn, and then say, who's going to teach me, who's going to take me to the tuition? Even when I ask my daughter that you can go through, you can do your self-study, but she also says that why to self-study, I'll ask my teacher. So this thing has really come to a very low point, that we always seek for gurus or teachers outside ourselves so that our path becomes easy. I never say that don't take a guru, don't take a teacher. I say when you have tried all those things out there and you are not able to achieve, or there is now there is no way left for you, that you have tried ups and downs and every bit of thing and you cannot achieve it, no peace is there, then you need to go to the guru. If you are trying, if you are practicing all those breathing techniques, if you are practicing meditation in your daily life, if you are practicing the watching techniques, the techniques which give you transcend, it may transcend, any technique may transcend you, which gives a inner turn to you. And if you are not trying it, then you need a guru. And again, guru is only the door. Guru cannot take you inside or outside. Guru can only show you. And if you are choosing the path to guru, then also the path is surrender. If you cannot surrender towards your anger, towards your ego, you cannot surrender towards anything, then also finding a guru is not going to help you. Is ultimately is going to increase your own misery. You are going to increase it by yourself. So I again say, I don't suggest a guru. It is also a false statement, and I don't even say that I suggest that you should go and search for a guru, is also a false statement. If you have not been able to achieve by yourself, then search for a guru. Please start with your own journey. Please start with your own ways. Please start with your own digging the well. Then only you can get water. And then there are a number of wells. You can just go and have to taste the same. So if you dig your own well, it is always going to taste beautiful at the end. So Remember this, trying to do technique is a must. Tantra is all about trying, is all about an inner journey, and you need to do it by yourself, okay? And today is the day to read the 29th sutra, my friends. And this is also a lovely 28th sutra, I should say. Yeah, we have done sutras till 27th, and this is the 28th sutra, which teaches you how you can attain. And most of the sutras are of reflecting, or of watching, or of visualization, or of breathing, or of physical. I think we have covered many of them, and many more will be there further. And this is a beautiful sutra, and this sutra, I have seen this happening in my original life. And this is about, imagine yourself losing all energy. I again repeat, imagine yourself losing all the energy. So you don't have to lie down, and you have to reflect, and then you have to reflect, imagine that you're losing everything and you're losing energy. No, it isn't saying this. Number of opportunities in your life. So this sutra is for person who is literally ill. There are n number of cancer patients. There are people who are struggling to survive. There are people who are trying their best and fighting a life and death thing out there, maybe in hospitals or in ICU. And that is the time where you can just connect with your own self. There is a lot of misery with the physical body, and when you suffer a lot of misery with your physical body, so true, Devendraji, it automatically it is like when you have a deep illness inside you, or if you are suffering because of anything, you can utilize that time, that misery, to connect with your inner self. And it has happened. I have seen people coming out like roaring lions. And to share with you all, my own sister-in-law, my bhabhi, suffered cancer, and it was like the second stage. And then she's still unaware of how she is connected to her inner being, but this disease of cancer has connected her inner being, and that is why she can enter into meditation. And I can see that, I can see her own connection to the center, and this connection has been established because of her suffering. And when she was suffering all these chemotherapies, there was nothing left with her, and it was a lot of misery which she has undergone with her physical body. And at that time she tried so many things to connect with her inner self, and now she's out of it. And she has regained, and she has just jumped out of all those misery. And now she is roaring out there and fulfilling her dreams. And she is more stronger, and she is a refined person than what she was before she was having cancer. And it is not about her success story. It is about, there are n number of success stories of people who just touched the death and they have bummed out. They have connected with their centers. They are at their centers. They work from their center. And we keep on missing it. We keep on missing every time. And this sutra may say that utilize those years, those times when your body loses energy or corrupt, and there is nothing left with you. That may be a time you can utilize. So it is not only suffering or losing energy from the physical body. Everything drains out from your life. So I say, when you have a lot of stress and there is so much to give away, and you are not left with penny, or you're not left with relatives, or there is no one to love you out there, people are lonely, people are suffering, so that is the time you can just utilize it to touch your own being. And friend, that is one of the moment I have also, and I was like desperate to know that what is beyond this. And and it is not that I know it, what is this, it is our way, our own journey to connect. And I'm going to tell you, it is not going to be the same truth for you. For you, the truth may be different. For me, it is different. And the number of people out there, the truth is different for everyone. So friends, I again want to push you all to try these meditation techniques, because now every biggest need. This is the time, the COVID-19 time has taught us that nothing is more important. All those Audis and all those cars and your sporty shoes, the brands, the clothing, the jewelry. If you have thousands of diamonds, they are also lying inside. What is going to help you is your own journey, is the peace. If you are at peace with your own self at home, that is what you have to attend. You need to start it now. And the upcoming generation, our kids, they may, if we are not going to improve, they may see a worse time. What we are seeing, this lockdown is we are hoping that this is the third lockdown after some time. But I don't know, if you're not going to improve or work with our kids, they may have a lockdown for their whole life. They may be closed inside. I hope you must have watched n number of Hollywood movies where people are locked inside buildings and they spend their whole life in it. And I think if you're not going towards a spiritual path, a path of awareness, a path of living together with the nature, then we are going to land up there. And that is the core reason why I started giving these sutras and talking about these sutras, because this is going to add value and add weightage to your personal life. And there is so much you can do, and there are techniques which can be used with the kids. So I'm going to come online and very soon I'm going to share what are the different meditation techniques you can teach your children also. But they are going to meditate if you are meditating. They are not going to meditate if you are not meditating. So friends, look inside. There's a whole lot of knowledge inside us and we can gain it. And here comes the 29th sutra. And this is also a beautiful sutra. It says yourself. And how can you devote yourself if you are full of anger, and if you are full of competition, and if you are full of comparison, and if you are sleeping and you are showing off, and there is so much to attend, and if you are running after money, then also you cannot devote yourself. And this devotion does not say that find a teacher and then devote yourself, or find a huge big cause out there and run a campaign and then devote yourself to people, to your people around you. Maybe your children and your spouse is there who is looking forward towards you. So devote yourself. And if you really have a cause, so devote. So the sutra says, be 100% devoted. And this sutra also says that when you surrender 100%, things automatically happens in this world. In whatever condition you are, in whatever pace of mind you are, in whatever life you are, the sutra says surrender yourself 100%. Accept the condition where you are living in. Accept, and then slowly, if you are going to accept everything, then you are going to forget that I have started devoting. Initially you need to think and then devote. Okay, no, I have to give my 100%. I have to be here and now. And slowly this forgetfulness also enters, and then you devote yourself 100% to the present condition, to the present life, whatever is happening. And if you are lucky in this lockdown and you are residing with the people you are loving, with someone with whom you have loved for your whole life, then this is the best period you can utilize this. Devote yourself to that person 100% and be available. Don't use your head or tricks to manipulate things. Just be there and be happy and try to feel it. When we talk about lovers, about two people who are in love and they are with each other, with husband, if I talk about relations and husband and wife, and you will see that they are talking about few things, and initially when they get married there are baby talks, and then there is more of lust, and slowly as the life passes out, if they are truly in love, there is no more to talk about. And still they are happy, they are sharing their life, they are there for each other, they are making each other comfortable. and they are sharing whatever the bond they have established and the experiences. So it's beautiful, it's so good if you are locked down out with your loved ones just now. And if not, then also you have so much in life to do and you have an opportunity that there is no one to disturb you. You can just close your eyes and you have a lot of time to do it. So every situation gives you something good. And if you are having this disease, then where you cannot get up from your bed or you are in pain, then also this is a good. So my friends, every time is very good and every time is precious. Utilize the time for your inner journey. That is where you can core of your center. So this is all for today, and I'll be joining you again tomorrow, and very soon I'll come up with few techniques only for children, few meditation techniques which our kids can do. And this is a high time again, I repeat that we need to teach our children also to meditate and understand that knowledge is something which they can gain from outside. It comes from inside. So see you then. Namaste. Take care.